Hi guys, David Fine from Watch Lit. Welcome to our Beach Fishing Fast Fish series where we're gonna teach you how to be a successful beach fisherman. We're gonna show you how to catch big fish. Today, we are gonna talk about the Silverside Run, how to fish the Silverside Run in Southeast Florida, one of the absolute most crazy things you will ever see. Trust me, check this video out. Guys, let's get to it. Guys, actually this year was the first year that I really got into fishing the Silverside Run, and I was blown away the size of the fish that you can catch on a bait fish an inch long. Silversides, otherwise known as the Bay Anchovy, Anchoa Micheli, it's literally an anchovy, guys, like the thing that you put on your pizza. And it's a great fish that pretty much everything from a houndfish, a little skinny little houndfish, or a 3-inch dork jack, all the way up to a 70, 80, or even 100-pound tarpon will all eat the same exact thing, a 1-inch Silverside. So guys, when the Silverside Run comes, it's unmistakable, because literally I walk down the beach and there's tarpon and snook flying into the air. Like, I'm like, what is this? This is crazy. There's tarpon flying everywhere. And so guys, what happens is these Silversides get pushed up on the beach by the predatory fish, typically late afternoons. You know, usually I see them between 5 o'clock in the afternoon all the way up until the sun goes down. And I saw from around the 4th of July this year all the way up until the end of August was just a consistent, constant cloud of Silverside school. And you know, and there's pilchards running around as well, but when the Silversides are there, the tarpon and snook really seem to be dialed in on the Silversides. In fact, if you use a pilchard that's 4 inches long, a lot of times during the Silverside Run, there's tarpon everywhere, and they will not look at your bait unless you have a Silverside on your hook, because they get dialed in to eating only that type of bait. They won't touch a mullet. They won't touch a sand perch. They won't touch anything else. But they'll eat a Silverside that big. Crazy. So guys, these Bay Anchovies, they pile up really super thick, and they come right up on the shoreline, and literally sometimes in ankle deep water, a wave will come and wash them up onto the beach. It's kind of crazy. But guys, there's tarpon literally flying out of the water, and I went diving and snorkeling and actually took my GoPro in there, got some of this great footage for you to show you what it looks like when these tarpon literally come and like gang up on, and they methodically, strategically attack all at the same time the Silverside school. So you'll see the tarpon, they come up and they corral them. The tarpon, 4, 5, 6 of them will be on the outsides of the school. They corral very strategically the bait up on the beach line, and it's kind of calm, it's kind of tranquil. The Silversides are going crazy. All of a sudden, the tarpon just start going all nuts at the same time. So they literally tag team the school. They might engulf 20, 30, 40 of them at a time, who knows. But at the same time, as that tarpon goes and does that, they crash through the school, it knocks a whole bunch of them unconscious, and then the other tarpon come in behind them and eat the stunned bait fish. And so do all the blue runners, so do the palmetto. The palmetto, it seemed to be, we would think of a palmetto as a sand flea feeder, crustacean feeder, but during the Silverside Run, palmettas turn their attention on the Silverside. So when the tarpon come through, the snook come through, and they do their little explosion thing, all the little tiny predatory fish, they come in behind them and pick up the scraps. So what does that mean, guys? Bay anchovies, Silversides, they are super wimps. And I say that because when you cast net them, first of all, you've got to have the smallest holes in your cast net possible, or they all get gilled and they die in your cast net. It's very, very, very annoying. And my son calls it a Christmas tree. You have all these fish hanging out, and they're gilled, and they die, and you can't use them. So you have to clean out your net. Always clean your net out, kids. Don't bring home dead fish stuck in your net. Leave it in the garage for your mom and dad to find in the morning. Don't do that, okay? Clean your net out before you come home. But you got to use a net with the smallest holes possible, and you throw your net and you put them in your bucket. You got to have fresh water with a good aerator system, and don't overcrowd your bucket. And the Silversides will live fairly well, but you got to pamper them big time. Now, here's the thing. What tackle do you use? I've tried weights. I tried throwing them out with weights, and they're so delicate. First of all, when you pick a Silverside up in your hands and you actually try to grab it to put pressure so that you can get the hook through it, most of the time you kill them right in your hands. Now, I've got big man hands, so maybe that doesn't help. But as delicate as you can be, you just got to really just put as little pressure on them as you can. You got to use as small a hook as possible. We actually started using those little mosquito circle hooks. They're really strong, but very, very tiny. They're like less than a 1/0 size circle hook, 20-pound fluorocarbon leader, 20-pound fluorocarbon leader, maybe, you know, a 4-foot piece of that, splice it right to your line, no weight. Get that? No weight. Here's why. You put your Silverside on your little hook, you toss it out, and when the Silversides are getting busted up, guys, your bait doesn't last 20 seconds in the water. It gets hit immediately. And you gotta sift through all the stupid houndfish. The houndies and the needlefish, they come in, they eat a lot of them. And you probably catch 20 or 30 houndfish for every one snook or tarpon. But guys, the snook or tarpon are there and they're gonna eat your bait. So you just keep doing it. You hook your bait, you throw it out a little bit past the anchovy school, and it'll start to do this, and they die within 20 or 30 seconds. So even the little tiny mosquito hook will sink your bait, but it's twitching and doing this, and on its way down, they get picked up by a passing by snook or tarpon or a jack or whatever, a blue runner, ladyfish, everything eats them, guys. So it's the most exhilarating thing I've done all summer long. I couldn't wait to get out to the Silverside run. Some guys bring artificial. If you want to bring a light tackle spinning rod, you can use like a 20-pound test braid and a light, really light fluorocarbon leader, and use a really tiny little bait, little tiny swim baits, white or silver in color, and they've got to mimic a Silverside. So if your bait is 3 inches long, it's not going to get hit in the Silverside run. It's got to be 1 inch or 2 inches long, really, really tiny, smaller hook, and you just gonna make it mimic an injured Silverside, and you're gonna hook up. I know guys, nice guy Dan hooked some tarpon this year, some snook, just using these little tiny swim baits. So guys, hope you enjoyed this video. If next July, August, get out onto the beaches in Broward County, look for those little black clouds around the beaches. Those are probably Silverside schools, and get in there with a cast net with some small hooks or some artificial and have yourself a good time. Catch some fish. Guys, let me know what you think of the video. Comment down below what you'd like to see next. Don't forget to give me a like and subscribe to the channel. We're trying to build our subscription base. Guys, we'd appreciate your subscription. We got plenty more videos where this came from. So guys, let's get out there and rip some lips. Until next time, watch a lip. Take care and God bless.